I became an alcoholic. I became a drug addict. But drinking was heavy on me, to the level that I was a professor in Puerto Rico in college, because I earned my degree in philosophy. But they had to put me out because I was drinking too much. And I interviewed doctors in here, and they told me, when they lied, you remained in the jungle. I was there in Vietnam like 4 months before I got wounded. Was on November 23rd, 1968. It was Thanksgiving Day, which is strange. It was like a terrorized moment, because I was among bullets. And my friend Ortiz, I love you, Ortiz. I got wounded too, then he got caught, and when I hold him, I saw when he twisted his eyes, and I had the feeling right away that he was through. Then when the helicopter flew him, they flew me and my other friend Ramirez. When we went to the hospital in Long Beach, which is a rough location at that time, the paramedic came outside and said to me, "Lionel, he didn't make it." You know, I used to wonder sometimes, I said, what I'm doing here? A young boy from Puerto Rico without knowing, because when they drafted us, we didn't know the language. Yeah, they did, you know, we didn't know English. And it was difficult to begin to digest the language. I mean, they used to send children with bombs to kill us. People don't realize those things. Sensation never leave us. Those experiences, it's like a tattoo, it always remain in our minds. Since that, I have been going to psychiatrists, to psychologists, every month. Now, healthy wise, many times I was taken to the hospital, my PTSD. One day when I was working, when the 911 happened, I was sitting in my cubicle when they told us to leave, to go home, because the Somerset, the airplane, and I was walking, and I said in my mind, now I realize why I was in Vietnam. Sometimes I wonder if I'm alive. Sometimes I go like this, touch myself, say, yeah, Lana, my psychologist, you are. I'm close to 7 years without drinking. And I feel happy now again. And I feel very, very proud that I serve for this country.